Hello, I'm Maruk Saeed, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Campylo means curved, bacter means rod, and jejuni refers to the jejunum, which is a segment of the small intestines located between the duodenum and ileum. Thus, one of the most frequent causes of bacterial gastroenteritis globally is the comma-shaped bacterium Campylobacter jejuni. Foods like poultry and unpasteurized milk frequently contain it. Let's now discuss the anatomy and physiology of microbes. Gram-negative Campylobacter jejuni is a comma-shaped bacteria with a thin peptidoglycan cell wall that prevents it from taking up the purple dye when gram-stained, giving it a pink or red appearance instead. It is a motile bacteria because it possesses a flagellum at one end that it utilizes to move around. It is also oxidase positive, which means that it can use oxygen to produce ATP, or stored energy. Last but not least, because Campylobacter jejuni is a microaerophile that prefers warmth, it thrives best at 42 degrees Celsius in low oxygen settings on blood agar types, including Skiro, Butzler, and Campybap. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. All right, so the fecal-oral route is the typical means by which humans get Campylobacter jejuni from animals. Stated differently, the bacterium is ingested by feces particles. In birds, Campylobacter jejuni is often found in the gastrointestinal system. Therefore, eating undercooked or raw poultry increases the risk of illness. In the same way that cows are frequent carriers, drinking unpasteurized milk puts humans at risk of illness. There's also direct contact with infected pets, notably puppies, which excrete the bacteria in their stool. Children who play with an infected pet are more at risk of contracting the infection. Last but not least, contaminated feces can get into freshwater sources like rivers and spread illness. Campylobacter jejuni may adhere to host cells and cause sickness once it is within our body thanks to a variety of virulence factors. Firstly, it possesses cell surface proteins including PEB1 and CADF, as well as filaments resembling fimbriae, which aid in its attachment to the mucosa of the colon and small intestine. There, Campylobacter jejuni drills into the mucosa with the help of its long flagella and spiral structure, releasing poisons known as cytolethal distending toxins. These toxins exacerbate the inflammation by harming neighboring intestinal epithelial cells. A toxic megacolon can develop when the colon dilates due to severe inflammation and injury. Bacteremia can also result from the bacteria's continued drilling until they enter the circulation. In response to blood-borne bacteria, the immune system may produce anti-ganglioside antibodies that target peripheral nerves and result in Guillain-Barré syndrome, a paralysis-like condition. Similarly, an infection may trigger reactive arthritis, an autoimmune inflammatory response in which immune cells target the joints. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Usually, symptoms appear 1 to 7 days after the incubation period. The typical course of symptoms includes fever, headache, muscle aches, and malaise. Cramping stomach discomfort and initially watery, foul-smelling diarrhea are subsequently experienced. The majority of cases of bloody diarrhea occur in youngsters. Difficulties may cause other symptoms to arise. On physical examination, bloating, tachycardia, and even loss of bowel sounds are signs of toxic megacolon. A characteristic of Guillain-Barré syndrome is ascending paralysis, which begins in the feet and progresses to the upper limbs. In fact, one of the most frequent bacterial causes of Guillain-Barré syndrome is an infection with Campylobacter jejuni. Last but not least, reactive arthritis causes pain in big joints. The diagnosis of a Campylobacter jejuni infection is made using the patient's clinical symptoms, a stool sample that is examined directly and reveals gram-negative, comma-shaped bacteria along with white and red blood cells, or by isolating the bacteria on cultures. Since the infection now normally goes away on its own, the mainstay of treatment is keeping the patient hydrated and addressing any electrolyte imbalances that may arise from vomiting and diarrhea. Antibiotics like erythromycin can be used for serious infections. Lastly, properly cooking meat, especially poultry, and washing your hands can help stop the spread of the infection to others. Keeping unpasteurized or raw milk separate from other foods, and keeping chicken in particular separate from other foods. Now, let's look into the summary. Campylobacter jejuni is a gram-negative, oxidase-positive, comma-shaped bacterium that is primarily found in poultry and unpasteurized milk. It grows best at 42 degrees under low oxygen conditions on Skiro, Butzler, and Campybap blood agars. Additionally, it is the cause of gastroenteritis, which manifests as fever, cramping stomach pain, vomiting, and bloody diarrhea. Guillain-Barré syndrome, reactive arthritis, and toxic megacolon are a few deserving problems to note.